Hi, good morning everyone. So we are going for the last part of our class, Mars in the 7th house. Hope we'll finish it today. I hope everybody is fine. So we have seen how his first novel, Swami and Friends, got published with the help of a great writer like Graham Greene. And now he is talking about his second novel. Thanks again to Graham Greene's recommendation, The Bachelor of Arts was published by Nelson, fulfilling a fancy I had entertained several years before when a Nelson representative had come from Edinburgh to see my father about the supply of books for our high school library. So this second novel has got published with this publishing house, Nelson. So some representative of this publishing house came to him because they had a school. So the representative want them to buy their books, these publishers' books. So R.K. Narayan tried to influence him at that time. I had confided to this salesman, he entrusted to this salesman to get something, to keep it secret also. If I write a book, will you ask your company to publish it? So that was his question. Undoubtedly, he had said and given me his card. So this is how she was introduced to Nelson, the publishing house which publishes second novel, The Bachelor of Arts. Change after February 1937. My father, again there was a change in his life. There was little prosperity, but again there was change. My father lived up to the last date of the month as if it is satisfied the technical need, and died leaving us to draw his pension for the full month. So in 1937 his father passed away, and he gave this pension amount. Full pension amount was drawn by the family for all the expenses, that is for the funeral and after death, connected with death ceremonies, and that was all the resources we were left with. And by that time they had only this money for making things up. My father had never believed in savings, property and such things. So they had never ever this properties or money with them, because he was a very simple man, R.K. Narayan's father, and he had never saved property or something for his children. So now we feared a total economic collapse. So there is no income to the house. So what they will do? But we managed. My elder brother, now back from Madras, as an experiment, had opened a small shop in a new extension and called it National Provision Stores. So his elder brother had opened a new shop and its name was National Provision Stores, and it was an extension of their own house. Sinu had a government job and moved off to Bangalore. Another brother had moved off to Bangalore. He has got a government job. Mine was still a pure gamble. His life was like a gamble, as all writers face it, because they don't have the surety of their novels getting published in future, or the money they will receive after the publishing of their works. It was like a pure gamble. Sometimes I wish that I had not given up the justice, but I was sustained by the gambler's inexhaustible hope and a macabre anticipation of something turning up. So he was sustained. He really thought those times that giving up the job in the justice, you know, how he was after the publication of Swami and Friends, how he wrote a letter to the editor of the Justice, saying that he will not be working with them. So, but again, I was sustained by the gamblers' inexhaustible hope. Every gambler has this hope. Next time it'll come. So it'll be successful. Next time it will be. No, they are very positive. They have this hope every time. So, like a gambler's inexhaustible hope, he waited. Macabre-ish anticipation. Macabre-ish is resembling a character called Wilking Macabre. Macabre in Charles Dickens' novel David Copperfield. So this character is very famous for his irresponsibly optimistic attitude. He is simply optimistic. So he is remembering this character Macabre-ish as he is very optimistic of his future. Something good will He was thinking that something good will happen in his life. With a second novel published and a daughter added to the family. So now there is a change again. He has his daughter, new member. Life seemed to be not so sad, but life was not sad. With all these things, he managed things. Short stories were being accepted in India as well as abroad. So meanwhile, the novels was on the way to get published, his short stories were being accepted by many editors in India and also abroad. Graham Greene helping me in London. So Graham Greene became a great friend and help for him. And by the help of Graham Greene, his short stories were being published in outside also. So after all my claim to the editor of the Justice about contacts with London editors was being fulfilled, although it had perhaps been premature. വലിയ ഇതൊക്കെ പറഞ്ഞു അവിടുന്ന് വന്നതാണല്ലോ. ഐ ഹാഡ് കോണ്ടാക്ട് ഔട്ട്സൈഡ് ആൻഡ് ദേ പേ മീ വെൽ. ബട്ട് അങ്ങനെ അല്ലായിരുന്നെങ്കിൽ, ഗ്രഹാം ഗ്രീൻ പബ്ലിഷ് ചെയ്തില്ലായിരുന്നെങ്കിൽ തള്ളൽ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞേനെ എല്ലാവരും. സോ ദ എഡിറ്റർ, ഹിസ് ഫേസ് വുഡ് ഹാവ് ബീൻ വെരി അഗ്ലി. So the great gods who could view the past, present, the future as one block would have realized I have not been false. Somehow the god helped him to come his words true to my make his words true because he had someone very influential in Britain to make his works published, and that is Graham Greene. So all his words to the editor of The Justice was not false. My brother and I shared the household expenses. He looked after the supplies and miscellaneous items of expenditure, and I had to see that the house rent was paid. So he paid his the house rent, and household expenses were being looked after by his brother. All aspects of shelter were to be my responsibility. Rama Vilas, in which we lived, was to be retained at any cost. So he cannot imagine of shifting this house because it requires so much of amount, money and physical resources. So he could not afford all this at this particular moment. There could be no question of our moving to another house. Fortunately, our house owner lived in Bangalore and only came down to Mysore once a month to collect the rent. So the house owner was a rich man, so he came only once a month to Mysore to collect the rent. So they had some agreement on the payment. This is that. I told him once, the rent is my responsibility. I had no fixed income. If my books sell, the royalty will come in only in December and June. So please permit me to settle the rent once every 6 weeks, although I will pay into your bank account whatever amount I'm able to earn meanwhile. So at this settlement, he told that it will take so many months to get the money transferred to his accounts after getting something published, and it is in the months occasionally December and June, so he cannot pay daily every month. So he asked it asks every 6 months, and meanwhile, if he gets some money, he will pay that also to his account. That was the agreement, and it was settled. He was a good enough. He was a good man, and he accepted it. He was a good enough. He was good enough to accept this agreement. Now I had a scrappy, fitful income from various sources. So it was like scrappy income, not organized, disorganized from here and there, not from at one particular place, but here and there, because he was publishing in various publishers, editors. So, fitful income from various sources. In addition to other items, I had to find money for baby food, gripe water, and toys. So, as a new member, he had this. His daughter baby, so baby food, their own needs are there. I did a variety of writing, humorous article every week for a merry magazine at 10 rupees a week. So his vocation, profession became writing. He has written for this merry magazine humorous articles. A most taxing experience for me to perform 1,000-word literary cloning week after week. So he had to create humor, joke, and that is the most difficult thing. And every week he has to write this, he calls it cloning, because he is creating jokes. I had also begun my third novel, The Dark Room. So while writing all these short things, he was writing his third novel, The Dark Room. So first is Swami and Friends, second Best of Us, third is The Dark Room. I took a pad and pen and disappeared every morning to for 3 hours. So 3 hours he will move away from his house. I found it impossible to write at home now. There were far too many worrying distractions, and also the baby. So many things will be there when we are in house, and especially the writers, they need a concentration, they need peace of mind. They can't write in a when so many responsibilities, distractions, they can't write. So he will move for 3 hours from the house. And she was just a little over a year old. So her daughter, his daughter, was 1 year years of old age, 1 year old. And I found it impossible to remain at my desk, and she was around when she was around, since my wife often left her in my care while she was busy in the kitchen or in the garden gathering flowers for my mother's daily worship. So his wife had, when she is busy with other works of house in kitchen or outside gathering flowers for his mother's worship, he had to look after the child. So when he writes, he does not want any distractions to happen, because it breaks the flow of the writing. So I had also a routine duty to carry my daughter, to let her watch the pink bougainvillea flower over the compound wall of Reverend Sode's bungalow at the corner. So every day he will take his daughter to the Reverend Sode, the neighbor's house, and there was this bougainvillea, and she enjoyed watching this. So he used to take her out. So in between, he needed to write. She would gaze at the bunch of flowers for about 10 minutes with rapt attention. So like all children look at flowers with so much of interest, this daughter of Akinarayan would look at it, gaze at it for about 10 minutes, and then I would have to lift her up to give her a glimpse of white terrier that barked and frisked about inside the reverend's compound. So there was this terrier, a dog with full of hair, terriers. So she was interested to watch that also. For that Akinarayan needed to lift her up so that she can see the dog. Only then could I be free to deposit her at home and leave. So after that duty is done, he will leave home. Before sending me out, my wife would give me a cup of tea, coffee, and sometimes whisper a warning, don't make a fuss. Not enough coffee powder at home. Get some at store when you return. So sometimes she will say all these words, household things to get. I set out to do my writing at the college union where the secretary had given me a room. So where he is going to a nearby college, and the college union, they approved. They gave me their room for him to write his work. I shut myself in for 3 hours, gazed on the green football field outside across the street, and spun out the fate of Savitri, the heroine of the dark room. So he will spun out. Spun out means made to continue for long time. Long time he will think of the character Savitri and write. This is the heroine of his third novel, The Dark Room. Looking at the gazed outside football field and the greenery outside the college. I was somehow obsessed with the philosophy of women as opposed to men. So it is his thinking about his philosophy about women. Women are opposed to men. How? Her constant oppressor. Man is always a constant oppressor that he realizes. This must have been an early testament of the women's liberation movement. So he finds his own novel as a liberation movement for women. Man assigned her a secondary place and kept her there with such subtlety and cunning that she herself began to lose all notions of her independence, her individuality, stature and strength. And through this novel, through Savitri, he tried to portray women's issues like and man as an oppressor of women. And through the way she was raised up in her house, in the society, how she was made a secondary citizen, and how the society was cunning to make her believe that she is secondary to man. And the notion of independence, she never think of herself as a free independent individual, and her strength she forgets everything because of the way this society is made up. The men are creating it. A wife in an orthodox milieu of Indian society was an ideal victim of such circumstances. We know how women of India are. My novel dealt with her with this philosophy broadly in the background. I wrote nearly 1,000 words before I went back home for lunch, exhausted but also feeling triumphant at having done my quota of work for the day. So his target for every day was 1,000 words. And he made sure that he completed 1,000 words before leaving for lunch. So this was his routine after publishing this Bachelor of Arts, and as a preparation of publishing this Dark Room. The Dark Room, once again read and approved by Graham Greene, was published by Macmillan in 1938. So again, a good news. Third novel was published in 1938 with the Macmillan, a very good publishing house. I had the unique experience of having a new publisher for each book. So the first publisher was different, second publisher was different, third it is Macmillan. So he is telling that I had the unique experience of having a new publisher for each book. One book, one publisher. Then perhaps he said to himself, hands off this writer. Hamilton, then Nelson, now Macmillan. So he started his first book with Hamish Hamilton, then second with Nelson, third with Macmillan. So it was like one book, one publisher. So he was telling himself that hands off this writer. So that with that, the chapter ends. The Autobiography continues, but the chapter for you here ends. I hope you understood everything. Remember the dates and important events that happened in his life. And that is, this is a simple autobiographical, a part of his autobiography. So hope you all understood. If any doubt, ask me. So you can message or call me. Please watch it. And thank you for listening. See you in the next class. Take care. Bye.